Marathon Oil is an independent upstream company that in its present incarnation is relatively new, only 2 years old. Well, to tell us more about how that's going, we're joined by Alex Herger, who is the Marathon Oil Vice President for Global Exploration. Now, it's 2 years since you were set up, the company split. How's it going?
It's gone very well. We really have taken the opportunity to reinvent ourselves from, you know, relatively a small major integrated company that had downstream refineries and marketing efforts, and now we are purely focused on upstream E&P.
But so you're involved in reinventing the company. Now your particular part is if you like conventional hydrocarbons, and yet there's a great emphasis elsewhere on the unconventional, on the all shale sands. So how does that work? How do you fit into this reinvention?
Well, the production department, the onshore production department in North America, is the one that's heavily involved in driving the unconventional business onshore. And you may have heard that we did a major acquisition of Hillcorp to get into the Texas Eagleford Shale 2 years ago. And so a lot of the focus is to get that up and running, and we've been very successful in doing that. Our production's up over 100,000 barrels a day now from essentially nothing 2 years ago. So 5 years ago, if you had looked at Marathon, we were a totally different company. We didn't have the unconventionals. We had gas stations and service stations and all different kinds of businesses, whereas now we're focused on being independent oil and gas. And the driver of that business is the unconventionals, primarily onshore. But one of the things that Marathon is different from some of the other purely U.S., North America-focused unconventional companies is that we still have maintained a global position. So we still have production globally, and we're still exploring globally.
Yeah, so your role really is to sort of fight the corner for the conventionals. How do you do that?
That's right. I'm a big believer that we need a balanced portfolio, and you need to be looking for the long-term future of the company. And so exploration's role is just that. It's what are the growth opportunities that are going to fill the pipeline, 5, 8, 10 years down the road. And so that's what we're looking for.
Yeah, so where are those opportunities going to be 5, 10 years down the road?
Well, the reason that I'm at the Africa Oil Council meeting is because we believe that a lot of it's in Africa. And Marathon Exploration is really focused in Africa. We've rebuilt our portfolio in Africa over the past 2 years, 3 years. Marathon's been in Africa a very long time. We've got a legacy position of over 13 million acres in Libya, right now under force majeure, but hopefully that'll get itself sorted out. There's still an enormous amount of potential left on that acreage position. We have a major position in Equatorial Guinea, which is throws off a lot of production and cash for the company. In terms of exploration, we have re-entered Gabon in the last 2 years and had a major gas discovery there with partners Total and Cobalt. And then we have entered into Kenya and Ethiopia as well with partners Tullow and Africa Oil. So Africa is a big focus for us, and we see that a lot of the yet-to-find potential in exploration, especially in terms of oil, lies in Africa.
Mm. Yeah. So where else do you think in Africa has got potential?
Well, our new ventures team is essentially looking at all the hot plays in Africa. So those would be the Equatorial Margin plays, which were opened up by the Jubilee field, but really looking down the whole West African margin from Morocco, Mauritania, around the corner into Ivory Coast and Ghana. We're basically looking at that. We are focused on the pre-salt play, on the West African margin, which is obviously the conjugate to what's been going on in Brazil. And that's why we entered into Gabon a couple years ago, into the Diaba block. And we are also negotiating a PSC as we speak in Gabon for that same play. Onshore, I think the rift basins have a lot of potential. There's a lot of rift basins in Africa, some of which have been proven, like Uganda and also Sudan. And now, of course, the Lakachar Basin in Kenya. There are a lot more basins like that that haven't been explored at all. So there's enormous running room of taking the kinds of plays that have been proven in one area and then exploring for analogs in other areas.
Now, you're also involved in the Women's Oil Council.
I am.
How significant is that development of actually having a separate women's oil council? I think it's very good.
It's just started out, and so I think we have the opportunity to shape it into what we want it to be. But it's really an opportunity for women who are particularly senior women in the industry to get together and talk about challenges and some of the struggles that maybe we have specifically as women. And also to think about ways that we can promote more women into management. There's not as many as you might see. Looking around the room, you see a lot of very few women senior leaders. So how do we promote the younger geoscientists and engineers into those positions? How do we even promote high school age kids to be interested in science? So that's one of the topics, I think, that we'll be dealing with, amongst others.
Alex Herger, thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thank you.